Good evening. Minister Bundridge, Board Chairman Charles Kraft, President Obera, Vice President Reeves, members of the Board of Trustees, faculty, administrators, candidates for graduation, families of the candidates, friends, and invited guests, welcome to Westmoreland County Community College 42nd Commencement Exercise. As a member of the faculty, I am proud to greet the students who have succeeded in taking a significant step toward a new future. The purpose of today's convocation is to confer degrees, diplomas, and certificates upon these graduates for graduation who have satisfactorily completed the academic requirements in their respective educational programs. Congratulations to the candidates, and once again, welcome to all. Would everyone please stand and join in the singing of our national anthem and remain standing for an invocation. It is my pleasure to introduce Minister Bundridge, who will now deliver the invocation.
Let us bow our heads in prayer. Heavenly Father, we just come to you, giving you all honor and glory, thanking you for this evening, Father, knowing that the race is not given to the swift, nor the battle to the strong. But we know that them that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They will ride out with wings of eagle and fly. They shall walk and not be weary. They shall run and not faint. We just thank you for the lives of these young people, Father, who persevered through their studies, some through athletics and study, some through athletic study and jobs. We just thank that you kept them on the right path. We just ask your continued blessings over their lives as they continue on this new path of their life. We honor you and we glorify you. In the name of your Son, Jesus, amen.
Thank you, Minister Bundridge. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present our president, Dr. Daniel Obera.
Graduates, families and friends of graduates, distinguished guests, trustees, administrators and staff, you can please sit down. We don't want to make you stand for the whole ceremony. It is my privilege to welcome you to the 42nd Westmoreland County Community College commencement. These are unprecedented times for Westmoreland County Community College. Tonight, we celebrate your graduation with an all-time college record of 950 graduates. Thank you for this outstanding accomplishment. Community colleges are well noted for the access that we provide by our affordability, open admissions, and accessibility. But now we have an expanded mission. The mission is completion. Completion of a certificate, diploma, or associate degree. As an Achieving a Dream Leader College, our faculty and staff are committed to enabling you to achieve your goals for degree completion. Why is it so important for you to complete your degree? You may have seen posters around campus that articulate the top 10 reasons for completing a community college degree. These reasons are based on research by various agencies. In case you missed them, here they are. You will earn more money. That is about $400,000 more than a high school graduate in a lifetime. And as the commercial says, who doesn't want more money? You will be prepared. People change jobs an average of 10 times in their lifetime. A degree will always give you an advantage. You will be more likely to retain a job. Unemployment is 30% lower than that of high school graduates. You will encounter fewer barriers to continue your education for a bachelor's degree. Four-year institutions are eager to accept community college transfer students who have an associate's degree. You will open doors for your children. Children of college graduates are more likely to graduate themselves. You and your family's health will improve. Research links greater college attainment to more healthy lifestyles and longer life. You will be more likely to promote environmental sustainability. You will be more likely to volunteer, vote, contribute to charity, serve on boards, and run for office. You will have the personal satisfaction of reaching your educational goals. And lastly, you will be an educated, prepared, and higher paid employee, providing support for federal, state, and local governments, and helping the national workforce be competitive and productive in a global economy. That is quite a list. And that is what your completion of a degree entitles you for the rest of your life. In short, it places you on a pathway to prosperity and helps our country maintain its prosperity. Congratulations upon achieving your dreams, and it has been our privilege to accompany you on the journey. As alumni and friends of the college, you will always be welcomed back to WCCC. It is now my pleasure to introduce the 2013 Distinguished Alumnus Awardee. Many exceptional students have passed through the halls of Westmoreland County Community College since we conducted our first classes, and many of these students have gone on to achieve great successes in their chosen professions or have made significant contributions to their communities. Today, it gives me great pleasure to present the 2013 Westmoreland County Community College Distinguished Alumnus Award to Chef Regis Holden. Chef Holden graduated from WCCC in 1993 with an associate's degree in culinary arts. He has gone on to earn professional certifications from the American Culinary Federation, including Certified Executive Chef and Certified Culinary Administrator. His work experience has ranged from large upscale restaurants and resorts to family-style chain restaurants, including his current position as corporate chef for the Eaton Park Hospitality Group. His many hours and awards include the Achievement of Excellence Award from the American Culinary Federation, Chef of the Year and President's Award from the ACF Laurel Highlands Chapter, and the Produce Excellence in Food Service Award from the United Fresh Foundation. And in November of 2011, Chef Holden was inducted into our very own Center for Culinary Arts and Hospitality Programs Hall of Fame. Since graduating from WCCC, he has made strong ties with our college. He serves on the Culinary Arts Advisory Board, established the WCCC Regis Holden Culinary Scholarship, and facilitated an articulation agreement between Eaton Park Hospitality Group and WCCC. It gives me great pleasure to present the Westmoreland County Community College 2013 Distinguished Alumnus Award to Chef Regis Holden. Chef?
Thank you. Thank you very much. And I'd like to thank everyone who was involved with the selection. It's very much an honor. It's very humbling. But what I really want to do right now is to congratulate all of you on today, the day of your graduation, and give you a little, few little tips for your career. Now, whether you're pursuing your first career or you're beginning your second career, I congratulate you on completing that first major step in that career path, and I wish you all success. Success. You're probably sitting there wondering, what's a cook from Eaton Park going to tell me about success? Well, I can tell you I've witnessed it and I've experienced it over my career. And I can tell you from my experience that there are only four things you need to keep in mind and only four things you need to do to be a success in any career you choose. The first one is to pursue continuing education. This isn't the end. You need to stay current with trends and technology so that you continue to be relevant within your industry. Now, in my case, they haven't invented any new animals in the last 30 years. Guarantee that. But cooking techniques have changed. Technology has changed. The popularity of different ethnic cuisines have changed, and how our guests eat has changed. My industry has changed. So will yours. Stay on top of it. Two, take opportunities to push the envelope and take on tasks outside your comfort zone. Now, I know that change can be scary and nobody likes to fail, but others will recognize the risks that you're taking for the greater good of the organization. Early mistakes in that learning curve are easily understood and forgiven, but the rewards for success are practically guaranteed. Three, become active in any professional organization within your career. The person you meet at the next function that you just don't have time to go to could very well end up being the person that provides the next rung on the career, on your ladder of your career ladder, excuse me. And finally, seek opportunities to serve others and give back. Volunteer. Mentor. Bring your career back 360 degrees. Pay it forward. That's all I've got. It's really that simple. And if you don't remember any of these four simple tips that I've shared with you today, at least remember the words of the great coach Vince Lombardi. There's only one way to succeed at anything, and that is to give it everything. I thank you and wish you luck.
It is now my pleasure to introduce our commencement speaker for this evening. In a few moments, we will confer degrees, diplomas, and certificates to the members of the Westmoreland County Community College Class of 2013. Throughout your time here, your family, friends, WCCC professors, and staff have supported you on your academic journey. Many other individuals, friends of WCCC, have worked behind the scenes to support you as well by serving on the college's Board of Trustees and Educational Foundation Board of Directors. They contribute their time, leadership, financial resources to many college activities, including those that fund scholarships for WCC students. Today, it gives me great pleasure to introduce as our commencement speaker one of our most active foundation board members and a tremendous friend of college, Mary Catherine Mochar. Yes. Ms. Mochar is the president of Arbor Industrial Supplies, a machine tooling supply business she founded 28 years ago in Greensburg. Her efforts in building a successful business have earned her several awards. She was recognized as one of the best 50 women in business in 2001, and 5 years later, her company was named one of the best 22 women-owned businesses in Pennsylvania. In 2002, the Greensburg District and Pennsylvania chapters of the Business and Professional Women's Club presented her with their Woman of the Year Award. From the YWCA of Westmoreland County, she received both the President's Award and the Racial Justice Award. The Winner's Circle of Westmoreland County presented her with its Advocacy of Women Award in 1997 and its Athena Award in 2006, which is a nationally known honor recognizing women for their business and professional accomplishments, mentorship of other women, and community service. While her list of awards is impressive, what's even more extraordinary is the number of community organizations for which she volunteers her time and leadership. She's a co-founder of the Westmoreland County Commission for Women and Families and a founding giving member of the United Way of Westmoreland County's Women's Leadership Council. Also for the United Way, she co-chairs the Faith in Action Steering Committee. She currently serves on the board and is a past president of the YWCA of Westmoreland County, where she also co-facilitates its Racial Matters Study Circles. She's a past director for District 3 of the Business and Professional Women's Club and past secretary of the Board of Directors of the Girl Scout Council of Westmoreland County and a lifetime Girl Scout member. Currently, she holds the office of treasurer on the Board of Directors of the Redevelopment Authority of Westmoreland County. At Westmoreland County Community College, she is a 15-year member of the Educational Foundation Board of Directors and served as president for 5 terms. For the last several years, she has co-chaired the foundation's annual fundraising dinner, the Chef's Table, which in 2011 surpassed $1 million in funds raised to support student scholarships. She is a member of the WCCC Alumni Association, and in this capacity has assisted with the association's annual Rose Sale at commencement to raise funds for student scholarships. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming as our 2013 commencement speaker, successful entrepreneur, community leader, and WCCC advocate, Ms. Mary Catherine Mochar.
Wow, I didn't expect such a prestigious introduction, but thank you very much, Dr. Obera. Dr. Obera, Board of Trustees, Foundation Board members, distinguished guests, administrators, faculty, families and friends of tonight's graduates, and you, the graduates. I am truly honored to be with you all this evening. I cannot think of a better time to be part of Westmoreland County Community College than on graduation night. It is the culmination of all the hard work you and those involved with you have done over the past several years and have waited for. It is also the beginning of a new and exciting chapter in your life. When I was asked by Dr. Obera to be one of the speakers tonight, At first, I said, why me? What could I say that would mean anything to the graduates? He said to me, Mary Catherine, tell your story. First, I want you to remember these three words, and Reed just said them to you also. Pay it forward. Now, you're probably thinking, she wants me to pay something, and I'm just graduating, and I do not have a job yet. Well, I do want you to pay it forward, but not just with money. So let me tell you a little bit about my life, and you might understand better. Some of you, especially if you are a little older and the non-traditional student, can relate in some way. After all, I am a lot like many of you. I grew up in a household with two parents and three sisters. I am the oldest. Our mother was fortunate and stayed at home while our father worked. Our dad worked at a company, the same company, for almost 40 years, and we ate dinner every night at 5:30 as a family when Dad came home from work. Almost everyone in our neighborhood was the same. We were very protected. We had one TV with maybe six channels. To get the news on TV, you had to wait until the 12 noon, 6 p.m., or 11 p.m. With technology today, news is instantaneous for all of you. We had just one family car and one dial-type phone on a party line. That meant several homes shared the same line, so when you picked up the phone and you heard someone talking, you hung up out of courtesy because it was your neighbor speaking to someone else. I went to school for 12 years where there was no diversity. Everyone looked like me. In high school, you could take college prep and go to college. You could take business and become a secretary, or you could go to the VOTEC and learn a skill such as auto mechanics or welding. I was fortunate and took college prep, and after graduating, went to college. While I was in college, I met my husband, got married, and had a son. It was difficult at times balancing everything, but we were happy. Then life changed in an instant for me. My husband was killed in an automobile accident and died 4 days later. I was a 21-year-old widow with an 11-month-old son. Because we were just starting out, we had no life insurance and no savings. So I had to get a job to support myself and my son. I left college and went to business school and majored in secretarial science. If not for the support of my parents at this time in my life, I am not sure what would have happened. I finished business school, fortunately, found a job immediately, and moved into an apartment with my son so we could be our own little family again. Life was once again moving ahead for me. Then, after 2 years, the company I was working for decided to relocate south, as many companies were doing at that time. One of the guys I worked with knew I needed a job, so he told me of a guy, or a friend of his, who owned an industrial supply distributorship and was looking for a bookkeeper. He was paying it forward. Because of his recommendation, I got the job. I did not know what an industrial supply distributor did, but I needed to work. I learned that an industrial supply distributor sold tooling to the manufacturing industry. Tooling used to cut metal and make products that we all use. This was a business I knew nothing about, but I found it fascinating. I worked hard and eventually became office manager and inside sales manager. All along, to learn more about this industry, I took courses on my own in machine shop, at the VOTEC, various classes here at the community college, and with various of our suppliers. After working there almost 10 years and helping this business grow sales every year, I became aware of what unequal pay meant for a woman working the same job as a man. I was receiving less pay after 10 years for doing a higher level job than a man who had just been hired. I knew I could not stay there, and so I got together with two guys from the same company and started Arbor Industrial Supplies. Many of the courses I took here at the college helped me now as a business owner. Computers were just starting to be used regularly in business, so I took more courses here at the community college to help me learn. We are now in our 28th year in business, and I feel very fortunate. Being a woman in a male-dominated industry was not always easy, especially in the 70s and 80s. It took a lot of perseverance to keep going at times, but there was always family, friends, and business associates who helped, paying it forward. Also, I have a great faith in God, and He has always been a part of my life. I had great mentors, and most of them were men who were customers or suppliers who took the time to help me learn the industry. I persevered and became one of a very few women in a manufacturing-related business. In the 70s, it was difficult for a woman to get a bank loan without her husband or father co-signing for it. I wanted to buy my first house, and I had struggled to save the 20% down that was required. No one would give me a loan without my father co-signing. Until after calling on several banks, one bank with a woman branch manager put her job on the line and gave me a mortgage loan, paying it forward. I promised her I would not let her down and made my mortgage payment every month, no matter what. The same thing happened when I went to get a loan for the business. Again, I was fortunate, and a bank manager had faith in me and gave me a business loan, paying it forward. Many times in my life, I would not have achieved my goals and dreams, even though I worked hard, had it not been for someone believing in me and helping me. So I started doing the same for others as my time allowed. I started paying it forward, and it has become a passion for me. If you listened while I told you about myself, you did hear those words, pay it forward. The term actually is from a movie. It is a way to make your community and the world a better place. If someone does something that helps you get ahead, you need to do the same for others. Paying it forward are unselfish acts of random kindness done for others. As you have seen from my own life, if there had not been certain people paying it forward for me, I would not be where I am today. I see people paying it forward every day, and you do too. Your family and friends who did things so you could attend Westmoreland County Community College and graduate. The faculty here at the college who went above and beyond so you could be here tonight. The Board of Trustees who continue to keep tuition low and make improvements to the college. Our foundation board of directors and staff and supporters of the college pay it forward by working tirelessly to raise money to provide scholarships, which many of you have benefited from. So now as I close, I am asking you as alumni to continue to pay it forward. You have a responsibility as a graduate of this great institution to help those students who will come after you. Your paying it forward can be to stay involved with the college in some way, as our distinguished alumnus has done, or help with your monetary support to ensure that students who need it will have scholarships to pay their tuition. When you become successful, and you will, always financially support Westmoreland County Community College in some way. Join the college's Alumni Relations Program, which encompasses the Alumni Association, who offers exclusive benefits to their members and provides opportunities for you to build upon your success. Pay it forward to Westmoreland County Community College, even if you go on to obtain a degree from another college or university. Remember, Westmoreland County Community College was here for you. Let me leave you with a quote from evangelist Joel Osteen. The real joy in life is not what you get, but what you give to people. Be their miracle or make their day, that graciousness will come back to you. What can you give someone today? Thank you. God bless you all. Pay it forward, and good luck in all you do.
Thank you for that inspirational story and sharing your words of wisdom. Our student speaker that's representing the WCCC class of 2013 is Diane Palmieri of Greensburg. Diane is graduating with highest honors and will earn degrees in baking and pastry and Dietetic Technology, Nutritional Services Management. She holds a bachelor's degree in human resources, but found that the field was not a good fit for her. Once her children were born, she included them when she was cooking and found it provided a great bonding experience while also teaching them about science, math, reading, and hand-eye coordination. She has taught children's cooking classes through our college for kids programs for a number of years. The strong reputation of our Center for Culinary Arts and Hospitality program drew her to enroll in credit classes and pursue a new career. An entrepreneur, she owns and operates Children's Cooking Connection, which provides hands-on cooking birthday parties and cooking lessons for children, and hopes to open a bakery after graduation. Please welcome Diane Palmieri.
Good evening, fellow graduates, family members, friends, faculty, and distinguished guests. I'd like to take this opportunity to extend a very warm welcome to all of you and to thank you for joining the graduating class of 2013 at our commencement ceremony. This is a wonderful and exciting milestone for each one of us. Graduates, how many of you are as thrilled as I am to be finished with finals? It's such a great feeling, isn't it? Everyone sitting here tonight was born equipped with their own special set of unique gifts and talents. You each bring something special to this world that only you can bring. You have an assignment in life nobody else can fulfill because no one else in this world has the exact same personality you do. The world needs your gifts, your talents, your smile, and your passion for life. When I was growing up, my dad always told me, whatever career path I decided to follow, I should be the best at it I could be. He said, if you choose to work as a garbage collector, be the best garbage collector this town has ever seen. This is true for all of us. As it turns out, this great advice from my dad, which I'd adhered to all these years, is also a quote from the 16th President of the United States, Abraham Lincoln, who very simply said, whatever you are, be a good one. There are a few things I would like you to think about as you leave here tonight and head off to begin the next chapter of your life. First, each new day is a gift, so approach life with some enthusiasm, some excitement. Please do not just be swept along going through the motions. Make each day count by choosing to use your gifts and your talents to make a positive difference in this world. Second, be willing to help others and to go the extra mile to get the job done. It's not always about what is in it for you or how you can get by with only minimal effort. Instead, think of ways you can leave things better than you found them. Third, find the work you love to do because it fills a large part of your life. When you find that work, do great work. Thomas Edison once said, "I never did a day's work in my life. It was all fun." My hope is that each one of us will be able to say the same thing. And last but not least, be fearless and take one small step each day towards achieving your goals and your dreams, and before you know it, you will reach them. In an interview with best-selling New York Times author Charles Martin, whose books are now sold in 20 countries in 17 languages, he told how he received a whopping 86 rejection letters before finally realizing his dream of becoming a successful writer. How many of us would have given up long before the number 86 was ever reached and missed out on the joy of fulfilling our dream? He said it was both gut-wrenching and painful to receive each one of those 86 rejection letters, but he still kept pressing forward. My hope is that as we each begin the next chapter of our lives, we will use the education that we have obtained here at Westmoreland County Community College to make the world and our workplaces better. Congratulations to each and every graduate. May this be the beginning and not the end of your journey to continue learning something new each and every day of your life. In closing, I'd like to extend a very special thank you to my family and friends for all of their love and support, and also a very special thank you to all the professors and staff of the Baking and Pastry and Nutritional Services Management programs. May God bless each and every one here tonight, and may God continue to bless the United States of America. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Palmieri. More words of wisdom for all of us to live by. Dr. Nicole Rees, Vice President for Academic Affairs and Student Services, will now present the class of 2013 to President Obera.
President Obera, it is with honor and pleasure on behalf of the Westmoreland County Community College faculty and administration that I present the candidates for degrees, diplomas, and certificates. The members of the 42nd graduating class of WCCC have demonstrated by attainment their worthiness to receive the Associate of Arts degree, Associate of Fine Arts degree, Associate of Applied Science degree, diploma, and certificate, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto as stipulated in the charter of Westmoreland County Community College.
Thank you, Dr. Rees. By virtue of the power and authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I hereby confer upon the candidates the Associate of Arts degree, Associate of Fine Arts degree, Associate of Applied Science degree, diploma, and certificate. Grand Marshal Hustash, will you please ask the candidates to come forward to receive their respective degrees, diplomas, and certificates?
President Obera and Mr. Charles Kraft, Chairman of the Westmoreland County Community College Board of Trustees, will present degrees to the graduates. Diane Hightower, Dean of Students, and Dr. Andrew Barnett, Dean, Public Services, Humanities, and Social Sciences, will identify the candidates for the Associate of Arts degree, Associate of Fine Arts degree, the Associate of Applied Science degree, diploma, and certificate. Student Marshals, will you please send forward the candidates?
Associate of Arts, Justin T. Allshaus. Kyle J. Baraka. Tiffany R. Campbell. Tracy N. Cardone, High Honors. Rebecca L. Dama. Edward E. Day. Shane C. Dowd. Tina M. Dahl, High Honors. Nina M. Altrincham. David B. Francis, Honors. Rachel A. Harris. Paul T. Harisic. Joanne J. Liu, Honors. James P. Mechanic. Maria R. McDonald. Walter W. Scott. John E. Sennett. Lacey A. Shaw, High Honors. Martin T. Schultes, Honors. Danielle Rose Sipes. Sherry J. Thompson, Highest Honors. Zachary R. Wink. Bernie Wires. J.L. L. Zimmerman. The Associate of Fine Arts, Desiree Brown. Bridget A. Hyrack. Kelly J. Lash. Cindy M. Markowski, High Honors. Melissa A. Reiniger. Jeremy M. Thompson. The Associate in Applied Science in Accounting. Help me out. Sapana P. Backett, High Honors. John A. Habel III. Chris Matiasic, High Honors. Stephanie N. Pokel. Linda M. Sanner. Rebecca M. Smith. Mary L. Wetrow. Erica L. Wilt, Honors. The Associate in Applied Science in Architectural Drafting for and Design Technology. Ryan C. Decla, High Honors. Sherwood C. Friel, Honors. Andrew T. Johnson. The Associate in Applied Science in Baking and Pastry. Christina E. Kraus, high honors. Brenna R. Ferris, highest honors. Diane M. Palmieri, highest honors. Jesse L. Flanagan. Carl Henry LaPastille. Jessica A. McAvoy, high honors. Sheila M. Montgomery, honors. Melissa K. Rolfe. Rebecca L. Rudy, high honors. Beverly A. Tominello. Tori L. Valana, high honors. Brittany L. Wirtz, honors. The Associate in Applied Science in Business Management. Jeanette A. Balsone. Michelle K. Behan. Julie E. Craig. Ashley L. Emmert. Sasha L. Freeman. Dana M. Guess. Blaine D. Greenewalt. Amanda J. Kendrick, honors. Benjamin C. Lewis, high honors. Marianne R. Lewis, high honors. Aaron D. Long. Karania L. Morrison, high honors. Nicole A. Nelivanko. Gary W. Nelson. Ashley M. Pletcher. Jennifer L. Ceccarelli Popellis. Christy L. Rogers. Cheryl D. Seig. Lindsay N. Smith. Jerry L. Trada. The Associate in Applied Science in Computer Technology. Matthew J. Accorsi, honors. Congratulations. James A. Alcorn, high honors. Clint E. Ambrose, high honors. Sean E. Brown, High Honors. Daniel W. Crossett. Vernon Franklin. Anthony J. Parator. The Associate in Applied Science in Criminal Justice. Brittany A. Carr, High Honors. Richard A. Champion, High Honors. Agnita R. Day. Brandy L. Downey. Aisha D. Eddins. Akila D. Goder Day. Jacob D. Hager. Hope R. Lenz, High Honors. Jason R. Miller, Honors. Katie M. Miller, Honors. Nicholas P. Oler, Honors. Brandon A. Riddle. Jan L. Pollock. Gregory A. Papalis. Lee T. Sheffield. Joshua M. Sipple. The Associate in Applied Science in Culinary Arts, Brooke M. Brenner, High Honors. Giuliano P. Giacopetti. Alan L. Kantorik, High Honors. Kimberly A. Little, Honors. Joshua J. Roth, Honors. Deanna L. Spaniel. Anthony J. Tackett. The Associate in Applied Science in Dental Hygiene. Corey M. Bisher. Amanda L. Brown. Emily M. Berg. Laura M. Drummond. Cassandra E. Effort, Honors. Caitlin R. Felker. Lauren N. Holbert. Allison R. Judicki, Honors. Brittany N. Mara. Taylor S. Mongon. Seneca L. Sleesman. Kelsia L. Standgroom. Katie L. Stickney. The Associate in Applied Science in Diagnostic Medical Sonography, Erica R. Cortell. Stacy E. Dix. Brittany L. Halford, Honors. Kayla N. Litvick. Anne Marie Marincelli. Stacy L. Strope. The Associate in Applied Science in Dietetic Technician Nutritional Services Management. Shannon L. Katana. The Associate in Applied Science in Early Childhood Education, Lacey N. Clark. Elisha L. Defbaugh. Stephanie L. Guillory. Amber R. Gwynn. Deborah S. Heiss, High Honors. Rebecca C. Keller, Honors. Crystal M. Kunkel, Highest Honors. Samantha A. McCarthy. Nikki L. Miller. Mika Sakuma, High Honors. Courtney J. Swearingen. Rebecca L. Tabaka. Nicole Villanueva. The Associate of Applied Science in Education, Pre-K through Grade 4. Allison N. Geary, Honors. Daniel L. Lochner. Ashley M. Magda. Sarah Millar. Jamie L. Mitchell, Honors. Brianna N. Weston, Honors. Carrie L. Zelenak, Honors. The Associate of Applied Science in Electronics Engineering Technology, Andrew M. Harold, High Honors. Thomas G. Staney. The Associate of Applied Science in Fire Science Technology, Aaron M. Rutherford. The Associate of Applied Science in Graphic Design and Animation, Jennifer L. Bailey. Michaela L. Klein. Megan S. Guerreri, High Honors. Cody J. Milliron, High Honors. Ashley N. Obradovich, High Honors. Brent Pollock. Marissa A. Schweigart. Lance E. Stiers. Lisa R. Vengen, Honors. The Associate of Applied Science in Homeland Security. Jacob E. Bell, Highest Honors. Kenneth R. Miller, High Honors. Roger L. Nelson, High Honors. The Associate of Applied Science in Horticulture, Shanna L. Mann. Kasaya E. Myers. Kelly L. Philpott. Michael C. Stell. The Associate of Applied Science in Human Services. Amanda L. Bogle, Honors. Pamela S. Galloway. Bani C. Gatlin Ali. Deidre M. Kowatowski, Highest Honors. Lisa M. Palmer. Ashley L. Pryor.
Associate of Applied Science in Machine Technology, Samuel J. McGarvey. Associate of Applied Science in Multimedia and Photography, Michael F. Basher, Honors. Matthew J. Close, Highest Honors. Charlene C. Fenton, Honors. Diana Fulton Harvey. Samantha N. Kelly. Jenny L. Lash. Dalton T. Smith, High Honors. Tori L. Woodcock, Honors. Associate of Applied Science in Nursing. Karen M. Alois, Honors. Emily A. Ansel. Tina M. Baker, High Honors. Kimberly Y. Barton. Lisa M. Burdett. Serena R. Carr. Grace E. Cox. Brianna M. Craig. Jody L. DeFilippo, Honors. Danielle P. Duchetayen, Honors. Dennis M. Franks. Jordan M. Gibson. Joyce A. Graham. Jody L. Guidus. William C. Harding. Stephanie L. Henninger. Clara S. Heston. Tanya L. Hull. Don M. Jordan, honors. Michelle L. Kapp. Jennifer R. Lott. Nicole Jean McLaren. Katrina M. Medved. Elena Mulvihill. Mulvihill. Larissa L. Omlor. Gina D. Orcutt. Teresa L. Redman. Bobby J. Rodino. Candy L. Rush. Arlene R. Silba. Lori Jo Stang. April W. Talton, high honors. Diana L. Tekoski. Sandra R. Valentine. Penny L. Washburn. Yolanda S. Webb. Amanda J. Welsh, honors. Angela D. Wolk. Associate of Applied Science in Office Technology. Sherry L. Bogle, high honors. Lindsay M. Cable, honors. Stephanie L. Canyon, honors. Alicia D. Lair, honors. Casey M. Lynn, honors. Lori A. Martius. Robert A. McCullough. Brandy L. Mellinger. Nicole Poth, high honors. Erica M. Prock. Heather A. Rickey, high honors. Hillary A. Rodenz. Kristen R. Stevenson. Jennifer M. Wesolowski, honors. Melissa J. Wisbar. Associate of Applied Science in Paralegal. Suzanne G. Brunetto, honors. Barbara M. Cook. Mindy E. Harmon, honors. Candace N. Jeffries. Darshelle L. Thornhill. Rhonda L. Trayer's highest honors. Associate of Applied Science in Radiology Technology, Brandon J. Baker, Honors. Kelsey M. Brown. Virginia M. Carr. Jennifer A. Fortian, Honors. Alyssa M. Fronzelio, Honors. Lena L. Gamble. Antoinette M. Geary. Julie E. Greytak, Honors. Edward J. Klosky, High Honors. Emily M. Pravini, Honors. Katrina F. Smith. Paige K. Spisso. Elise M. Stevens. Chelsea E. Vella, High Honors. Jennifer N. West. Kayla M. West. Christopher R. White. Gina M. Zatelli. Associate of Applied Science in Restaurant Culinary Management, Heather M. Harbison, Honors. Associate of Applied Science in Science Technology, Robin L. Soriano. Jennifer M. Williams, Honors. Associate of Applied Science in Robotics Technology, Travis M. Inks, Honors. Associate of Applied Science in Web Technology, James W. Casper, Highest Honors. James C. Roll. Christopher W. Koons, Highest Honors. Valerie J. Smith, Highest Honors. Cassandra L. Todd. Associate of Applied Science in Welding Engineering Technology, Jeremy D. Romanko. Diploma in Medical Assisting, Leandra N. Baranek. Ashley M. Chapel. Lindsay M. Markovich. Beth A. Niederheiser. Tracy L. Struel. Certificate in Baking and Pastry, Amy L. Lighthall, Highest Honors. Tammy J. Swift. Certificate in Business Management, Sabrina M. Bazar. Charlotte K. Bonvenuto. Honors. Michael R. Kordowski. Carrie Sue McAnellan. Rebecca M. Thomas. Honors. Certificate in Computer Accounting and Tax Specialist, Sean D. Austin.
Good job, bud.
Certificate in Computer Technology, Matthew J. Gaze. Certificate in Education, Pre-K to Grade 4, Alicia M. Rue. Certificate in Expanded Functions Dental Assisting, Dana L. Bowser, highest honors. Jessica A. DePalma. Aaron A. Frazier. Brittany P. Janicek. Crystal J. Kelly. Ashley N. Miller. Mary A. Peternell. Elizabeth A. Pearl. Andrea L. Sabick. Brittany J. Wilson. Natural Gas and Oil Technology Certificate. Thomas W. Grundy, highest honors. Certificate in Office Technology, Tina L. Blystone, honors. Tammy D. Ridgway. Lindsay E. Soltis.
At this time, I would like to ask that all graduates move their tassels to the left. Congratulations to Westmoreland County Community College's 42nd graduating class. Now I would like to introduce Mr. Charles Kraft, Chairman of the Board of the Trustees of Westmoreland County Community College.
Good evening, and thank you. I have a small task to perform today, and that is to announce that the Governing Board of Trustees congratulate our graduates for their academic achievement, and the trustees also commend the administration, the faculty, and staff for a job well done in preparing the 2013 graduates. At this time, I want to introduce the trustees in attendance. Please hold your applause, and the trustees are, in alphabetical order, Chad Amon, James Boggs, Dick Dickert, Bridget Johnston, Dirk Mattson, Jess Stairs, and John Wright. They're an outstanding group of governing men and ladies, and I've enjoyed working with them, and they make this possible. I thank you. Good evening. Have a good one.
We will now ask for everyone to please stand for the benediction by Minister Bundridge.
Before I give the benediction, this is my opportunity to pay it forward. If you don't have a relationship with my dean, with my professor, I offer you this opportunity to have a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, because you're going to have to make decisions after you graduate. They're going to not only impact you, but impact your families, impact your friends, impact everybody. I'm going to leave you with this scripture before I give the benediction. Colossians 22 through 24. Servants, obey in all things your masters, according not to the flesh, but not to eye service, nor for man pleasers, but in the singleness of heart, fearing God. And that whatsoever you do, do it to heart, as doing it for the Lord and not for man, knowing that of the Lord ye shall receive a reward of the inheritance, for ye serve the Lord Jesus Christ. May we bow our heads. Heavenly Father, I thank you for the lives of these young people as they put on a foundation here at WCCC, Westmoreland County Community College. We just thank all the professors for their diligent work. Thank all our students for taking the time to study, to maintain their degrees, to go on to further their educations or hand out what life has to offer them. We ask you to cover them in their coming and going. Keep them covered under the feather of your wings. These things we ask in your Lord Jesus' name. Amen.
This concludes the 2013 commencement ceremony. There will be a reception for graduates and guests immediately following commencement in the Student Center and cafeteria. Will all guests please remain seated until all of the graduates leave the gymnasium? Congratulations to the graduates and best wishes to all.